Hello, my name is Larry Lloyd and I am a Community Safety Officer with Derbyshire Fire and Rescue Service. At the moment we are spending a lot more time in our homes than usual and today I am going to show you how to make sure that we keep our homes safe. The easiest way to protect your home is to install smoke alarms. Smoke alarms will give everybody an early warning of a fire and should be fitted on every level of your home and tested weekly. There are many ways a fire in the home can start. Almost 60% of all fires in the home start when cooking. Never leave your cooking unattended. There are many distractions in the home and people often lose focus. Setting a timer is an easy way to make sure you remember what you are cooking. Pans of hot oil or chip pans are incredibly dangerous. A deep fat fryer is safer. However, cooking oven chips is much safer still. If you do have a chip pan fire, please do not try and put it out yourself. If it is safe to do so, turn off the power supply, leave the house, making sure to close all the doors behind you, and when safely outside, call 999. The next most common cause of house fires are the electrical appliances we find in our home. Avoid overloading your plug sockets and never plug one extension into another. Be particularly careful when charging laptops, tablets, mobile phones, and electric cigarettes or vape machines. If you can, turn off all your electrical equipment when it isn't in use. And when you're doing the laundry, try and use your washing machine and tumble dryers during the day when you are able to monitor it. Always keep matches and lighters out of the reach of children. If you or someone in your household smokes, make sure to use an ashtray. And always double check that your cigarettes have been properly put out. Don't smoke in bed, and where possible, consider smoking outside. Candles and tea lights can be dangerous and should be always placed in appropriate holders and placed far from anything that could possibly catch fire. If you leave the room, make sure that you blow out the candle and remember that children and pets can knock candles over, which can be very dangerous. If you have an open fire or wood burner, make sure you keep them clear of any flammable materials. Ensure your chimneys are swept regularly, and wherever possible, keep the doors closed and use a fire guard. If you use a portable heater, don't dry clothes too closely to it. Keep them clear and unobstructed. If you are unlucky enough to have a fire in your home, then as I said before, smoke alarms will give you an early warning. This will tell you and everyone in your home to carry out your escape plan. It is important to discuss and practice your escape plan with everyone in your home and also carry out a bedtime routine. Turning off all appliances and electrics that aren't being used and closing all doors will minimise the risk of fires starting and spreading and protect your escape routes. Ideally, keys should be kept close to your exit doors and your route should be clear and unobstructed. Upon hearing a smoke alarm, wherever possible, the whole household should come together and simply leave the home through the nearest exit. When you are safely outside, call 999. Do not go back into the house for any reason until the fire service say it is safe to do so. If you are unable to get out of the house, then stay in one room, all together. Close the door and where possible, plug the gap at the bottom of the door. Open the window and call 999 or shout for help. And wait to be rescued by the fire service. Only as a last resort should you try and escape via a window. But please use this video to help make sure your home is as safe as possible and check for more advice on the Derbyshire Fire and Rescue website. To see if you are eligible for a safe and well visit, please call one of the phone numbers displayed. Please stay safe and well, and thank you for watching.